So I was working through my Notion content calendar recently, and I pressed this button and pressed this, and I noticed something, and I went, is this a bug? Why is the name popping up? Oh wait, Notion literally hadn't had the templates show the title of the template after you make them in years, and they finally did it. They've actually done a lot of different updates with templates recently that I'm gonna go through in this video, and if you wait till the very end, I'm gonna show you one that is absolutely gonna change the way that you look at synced blocks moving forward. And it's been a complete game changer for how I set up all of my templates. So obviously you can do that where if you make a new template, for example, if I take this one and duplicate the template, which by the way, if you didn't know, you can do that. You'll see that if I make a new video with the duplicate one, it'll say the title of the name. Now this is very useful for things like taking out the trash or doing different chores on a task and event calendar one. And I love that so much. Another great one that you can see here is if I go to my main content calendar, what I can do is I can set up this YouTube calendar one to make the video template that I have as the default. So if I press set as default, and then only on the YouTube content calendar view, when I make a new one, it'll automatically go to that template, which is beyond convenient, if you couldn't tell that I didn't have to click anything. I mean, I personally think that's dope. What about you? This makes a lot of contextual sense for different views that you'd have, like how I have a podcast one on the same content calendar, and I could set this as the default, or as a newsletter one as well, I could set the newsletter for Productive Brew as the default too. Now, if you have a workspace that would mean that the only thing that matters is one template for some reason, you can set as default to all the views in content calendar, and that is the name of the database itself. In this section here, you have a similar set of functionality where you can show calendar by, or where you can change the open pages in and set to side peak or center peak, and you could change the default for the different types as well in a templated manner. So when working with a new page, for example, if you wanted to have a ad hoc task, so a lot of people like to work with projects moving forward, and something that I've shown in previous videos is having synced blocks. So if I take this project task and put a slash synced block here, something that would happen before is if I made a new task here from the project task and then made another one, these two synced blocks would be the exact same. But if I type in here and type in here, that's how it is now. But something that's interesting that Notion recently did is if you made a template button where you put a synced block here and then press add new and add new, you'll notice that while these work together, and I completely botched this video, that moving forward, apparently they're changing that so that it wouldn't be together. So this was made by a video 2 weeks ago from a fellow Notion consultant. And as you can see by the title, Notion got rid of this feature. The main reason that I made this video was to show you a nice tip and trick for a new feature that Notion sadly rolled back. So if you guys really would like this to change and it to go back, complain to Notion, because that's kind of ridiculous that they got rid of that. What isn't ridiculous though, is the fact that you can still do that new template update and it's much better than it was prior. But what would make it even better for you to do more work in the future would be checking out this video right here.